Linear models actually use the simple idea, but there are many different ways of implementing these ideas. So we have not a single linear model, but there are many different linear models. Today we are going to talk about the concept behind the linear models. Then in the next lecture, we are going to see the implementation details of these models. So linear models are a class of models that are widely used in practice and have been studied extensively in the last few decades, with roots going back over 100 years. Linear models make a prediction using a linear function of the input features, which we'll explain shortly. Remember that from high school, I believe, for regression, the general prediction formula for a linear model looks like as follows. So you here see the x0s here, x0, x1, and it goes to xp. So basically, you can think of the x is a vector. So we have the values for x0, x1, and xp. So how many number of elements in that vector? We have the p number of elements. So you can actually think that x actually is the feature set. Like all the features. All right. Now here you also see that we have the w0, w1, and wp. All right, so you can think the W here, the W is also a vector, and W stands for weights, and it has the weights, first weight, second weight, and it goes like how many weights? Total we have P number of weights. And lastly, we have a bias here. So bias actually is just a simple scalar value. So let me put the bias here. Just the number, like, I don't know, for example, 5.0. It's a scalar value. So the weight and the x are vectors, but bias is just a scalar value. That's all. Now, by using these simple ideas, we can create our model. So the x vector gives us the features, as we talk, okay? And gives us the features. And the number of the features, p, so whatever the number of features, W is another vector. B is a scalar vector. And they are called together parameters of the model. Okay. So model tries to learn the correct W and the correct B using the trained dataset samples. So we say that model will learn W and B. Basically, we are doing a calculation on the training data set to find the correct values W and B. For what? For predicting the Y hat value. Now, here you have the Y hat. So what we do basically, we multiply every element in W with every element in X, as you see here, and then add the bias to calculate a value, and we expect that this value, the prediction, will be equal to the correct label, correct value in the data set. So we would like to learn W and B values. W and B are the parameters of the model. So we would like to change this model according to the trained data set, so that our predictions will cover the real true labels. Here is the terminology for parameter. W is weight, bias, B is bias. Here it looks like a little bit complex, but actually if you look at that for a single feature, do you remember this formula from somewhere? It is the equation for a line. Remember that in line, it begins from somewhere. Let me draw a beautiful line, not myself. I will use like that. Okay. In the line formula, we can calculate the given line. Here is the B point, right, on the y-axis. And on the x-axis, remember that we have the, anybody remembers what we have here? Interception, right? So basically what we do is that we are providing the slope and the B, and we provide this for any x point. When you provide any x point, for example, 2, you can calculate the y point, which is will be on the line. Is that right? For if you provide x here, you will calculate the y, and when you just draw this y and x, it will be on that line. So that's the thing. So what we do, multiply the x value with a weight, add a bias. This weight is the actually slope. This bias actually is the interception of the line with the y. Okay. So here with a single feature, we try to create a line and finding the w and b in that line. So w is the slope, the weight is the slope, b is the axis offset, the same idea with interception. Okay. So by using the multiple features, all right, now we need to have multiple weights. Okay, that's the idea. Multiple weights for each, let me put like that. For each feature, we have a weight. Okay, for each feature, today I'm not lucky with Zoom. So for each feature, we have a weight, and then we have a global bias, intercept, offset from the y. So by using this, we would like to end up with a correct as much as prediction when you multiply and add up this. Okay, so you can think that it is the weighted sum of the features. So these are weights. So using the feature values, for example, the size of shoe, okay, you use and multiply the shoe size by something, adding some bias, then you try to find the weight of the person. Okay, that's the simple idea. But we need to find the W and B such that your calculation of, in that example, the weight of a person should be correct as much as we can do. So we need to find the W and B. Nobody gives us. So how can we find the W and B for the given feature and target value? Now assume that that's the training data. In the training data, you are given several samples. So please pay attention that in these samples, okay, for example, that sample, okay, assume that on the this X is the feature, and assume that the feature is the shoe size, okay, shoe size, all right, and y-axis is our target, so we would like to predict the weight of a person, just assume, okay. Now, for that sample, this is the sample from train data set. The shoe size is 2, okay. And we would like to predict the target value. Actually, we know that because it's in the train data set, actually we know it is target value, but it's using all the samples, we try to find the target value by using a line equation. How can we do this? Now, if we have the line equation, okay, if we have the line equation here, and remember that the line equation is W times X plus B should gives us the Y hat. So Y hat is the prediction. Here you can use the two times some W plus B should give us, for example, 1.2. All right. But here you notice that actually if you use the this W and this B, it will be actually 0.8. You notice that? 0.8. If you plug this W here and B is here. Now, how much it's correct? You can calculate the error here like that. The correct one is Y minus, incorrect one is Y hat, the prediction. So 1.2 minus 0.8, our error will be what? 0.4. Most of the time we get the error squared. Okay, now it's gonna be error 0.16, right? So this is the error between the real value in train and prediction using this line equation W and B. Is that clear for so far? Okay. Now, if you apply this idea for every sample in the training set, you can calculate an error for every element I, right? Then you can normalize this by the number of elements or samples in the data set. Now you have an error rate, right? Okay, error. So, but the error actually is, pay attention, that square error. Is that right? So it's called mean square error. Mean means average. Square means that we get the square of the error. And don't forget, it is all the sample errors. Now, after calculating this error, you know that your model can fit how much to the train data. Instead of drawing this, maybe you can draw this line, or you can draw this line. Huh? How many lines you can draw here? How many lines you can draw here? How many lines? Infinitive number, right? Right? Yeah. You can draw infinite number. So for each line, you will end up with a mean square error. Is that right? For each line. Which line you are gonna select as your model?
With the least error.
With the least amount of mean square error, right? So when you decide your line, actually you decide the W and the bias of your line equation. Am I right? So you select your W and B, because this blue line, right? This blue line will have its own W and B. Huh? For that, we have another W and B. Am I right? For this blue, we have another W and B. For this green, we have another W and B. So notice that the formula is the same, but you have different W and Bs. At the end, you have different mean square errors. And you select the lowest mean square error possible. So actually you mean that you are looking for W and B, which minimize this mean square error. So that's whole story about linear models for regression. Any questions? So we are looking for W and B, minimize the mean square error. So when you decide the W and B, formula is the same always. W times X plus B gives us the prediction. Okay? But we need to find, it means that the model should learn. Actually, it means that find good values for W and B, which makes this calculation Y hat, and then calculate the mean square error for every sample in the train set minimized. Okay, I think it's clear. Any questions? So we how to put this? Actually, we begin with W and B. We can change it. Okay. So we didn't, I didn't explain how to define the, how to calculate, how to find W and B. I said that we need to find it. I said that model should find W and B. I didn't explain how it's possible. I just say that you can draw randomly draw infinite number of lines randomly. For each line, you can calculate the W and B's, right? You can calculate W and B for this line. Am I right? Yes, because if you go like that, you will x 8, for example. So B is minus 8 because where intercepts this line with the Y. And the here is the slope. So slope is the W. But how can you find the correct W and B or the optimum W and B? I am not discussing. I am just saying that if there is a line, you can come and find the W and B easily. Then you calculate the minimum square error and note it down. So you can select one line with the minimum mean and mean square error. Is that okay now again? Is that okay again? Okay. Because I will explain later, but now I am just giving an introduction. So there could be different lines. Calculate the minimum square error, select the minimum with that. So it means that you select the W and B in the formulation. That's all. All right. So the intercepts gives the B. So what is B here? So you are looking to the Y axis. And the line, it is intercept here. Actually, you can say that it's minus 0 point something. Okay, the B is like that. So let me say that in that line, B is 2.1. In that line, for example, B is minus 2.5. Now, everybody understand B, wherever you intercept it, Y, the offset value. Okay, so the slope, you can calculate the slope by using these X and Y differences and the ratio between them. Okay, so basically you divide the difference in, if you like, I can put, here is the difference in theta Y, here is the theta X. So M, which is slope in mathematics, in W in that sense, will be half theta Y over theta X. Okay, it's simple. All right, let's continue. So we, for the prediction, we provide a line for a single feature, but if there are more than one feature, what we are gonna do? We need to define not a line. Now, if there are two features, we have, let me draw it beautiful. Now, assume that we have two features. Okay. Now, we have three-dimensional space, right? In three-dimensional space, we have a data point. Let me put it here, data points, samples, but they are in three-dimensional space. So line is not enough. What you need to do? You need to create a plane. Okay. So this plane will separate left and right, upper and down. Oh, I can make it maybe better this way. Let me try. Now you can create this kind of plane. Now the plane can separate this space into two parts. So you can say that, for example, the upper side of the plate and the downside of the plate or the surface of the plate. Can you understand? If there are two or three or more planes. So if we say that it is higher than two, three or more, then we are naming it a hyperplane. This is getting much more mathematics, but I don't want to get into details because we are engineers. We are not gonna create these models from scratch, but you need to understand what we are dealing with. So understand that if it is a single feature, drawing a line helps us to predict. But if it is two features, then we need to use a plane calculation to predict the target value. But if it's more than two features, then you need to use a hyperplane calculations. But we are not gonna write the calculations actually. It's just theoretical part. But we will need to understand how to use the parameters to set the complexity of the each model to prevent the overfit and underfit. Okay. So if you think that a single line is not enough for predicting these values correctly, but this is only one feature. Don't forget, if the number of features gets more, we are gonna drawing, actually think of that, many more lines. So a plane actually is in two dimensional line, you think of that. So in hyperplane, there are more. So you can think of that, if the number of features gets more, the higher dimensional data set, then you are gonna use many more, let me say, lines, so it will fit better. All right. So here you see that nine neighbors in the KNN looks like that. And here now we have this one. So it looks like very simple idea, but it works when the feature number is not only one, two, but higher. So we are gonna use the linear combination of these calculations. It can fit higher dimensional data much more better. Okay, so the linear models can be very powerful for these many feature data sets. If you collect or select a data set for your feature, for your project, you need to pay attention to the number of features, the dimensions of data sets, and then you need to think about the model. So linear models are good for higher dimensions. For the regression, it is the same, but the calculation of the optimum W and B are out of the scope of this course, but I will give some insight for this later. So by setting the W and B, actually we decide the complexity of the model. So if it's a higher dimensional data, there are many features, then we are gonna use, let me say, many lines to fit the data. So you can increase the W and B in such a way that you can overfit the data actually. So it is a dangerous point for us. So the linear models are powerful models. It means that if it's powerful, it can get complex very easily. If it gets complex, it means that it can overfit and we don't want overfit. So we need to tune the linear models somehow for that model complexity. So it is just an introduction for the linear models. We are gonna see three kinds of linear models in the next lecture. And we will deal with the overfitting, underfitting, and how to you tune these with these models with parameters. So do you have any questions?
Yes, sir, I have a question.
Yes, please.
Sir, in the regression problem, we are approximating it, the model with a line or a plane. So although there are some points that lie like away from the line or away from the plane that we are approximating. So in the regression problem, when we approximate a line or a plane and then a new point comes, then the model will just put it on the line or on the plane. It will never put it away from the line or the plane, right?
Of course, yes.
Yes.
Okay. So the point is that you make, so here actually we draw this line and at the train time, right? These are the train data set. We already have some errors, right? Numan?
Yes.
For example, this point, when you provide the X value, let's say 1.8, you think that it is on the line, according to line equation. You would say that it is 0.5, but actual value is 0.7, let's say. Okay?
Yes.
So for yes. here, if the point is not on the line, even here, there is always error. Here, yes. even here, it should be like that, and it's almost maybe impossible. But let's say that it's on the line equation, then there is no error. But for other points, there is some large or small errors. So what I explained that we are going to see next lecture, we can calculate the error by squaring this y minus y hat and normalize with the number of the samples. Now it's called mean square error. Of course, this error happens in the train and test time. Okay. Assume that what happens in the test time, let me show you if you like. And now assume that, forget the left side, okay. Now assume that test examples. The red ones are test ones, okay. So how can you predict them? How can you predict the values of this? So it means that actually in test data set, we provide you the X for each sample, you provide the X, but we don't provide you the Y. We keep Y for us, but when you get X for this example, 1, you go to there, you find the point on the line, and you guess Y hat, so assume that 0.8, but in the test data, actually it is not that 1.2, so it's Y, so this is Y hat, so you just calculate the error for each test point as well, okay? And then you have another accuracy in the test. In real life, you don't have the these y's, but you have only x. So you cannot calculate the error. In the test you can, but in real life, you have only y hat. Am I right,
Numa? Yes, sir.
So you don't know the coordinates. Here, the coordinates you don't know. You only know the X points in real life. So by using these X points, actually, you hope that you have the X point and you find the Y hat here and you tell your customer that the guy will be weight 80 kilograms. But you don't know the mistake in real time. In text time, in test time, you know, in train yeah. time, you know.
Yes, is, sir. Wonderful.
Is it clear for you, Numan?
Yes, sir. Absolutely.
Okay. Anybody has any questions? Okay. This is the introduction to linear models. Next lecture, we will continue with linear models and we will learn how to use them by setting their parameters accordingly. See you next week.